What's your overarching impression of week one, Albert? What do you got for me on that?
You know, and I think this is sort of like an abstract thing, but I try to like think like of like big league trends, you know, after the first week, because I don't think it's, you know, I don't think you should be crowning anybody or indicting anybody in week one. And so the one thing that really stuck out to me, Rich, was seeing the way Patrick Mahomes and Tom Brady sort of lifted their teams up and made it so their teams didn't need to be perfect. And, you know, you think of the Chiefs getting off to the slow start, falling behind by double digits. You think of the Bucs turning the ball over, you know, Godwin dropping what I think we all expected to be a touchdown pass, fumbling inside the five, you know, in the fourth quarter, and how these guys had this great ability to just kind of erase all of it. And, you know, in a roundabout way, Rich, it made me think about like what the Rams did this offseason and what the Niners did this offseason. The Rams and Niners both had quarterbacks in their 20s. Both those teams had been to the Super Bowl with those quarterbacks. And, you know, now both those quarterbacks, both those teams are moving off of those quarterbacks. And, you know, it's obviously happening more gradually in San Francisco than in Los Angeles, but the idea is the same. And I just think it's, I mean, I know that this is after 1 week and everything else, Rich, but I think it's the Mahomes-ization of the NFL. Like, I think it's like we're at this place now at the quarterback position where just being good isn't good enough. And I think you can even connect it to like the Dolphins potentially moving off of Tua this quickly to go in to get Deshaun Watson. Now, who knows if that's going to happen 6 months from now? Maybe it will, maybe it won't. But it's just, I think, another example of the way people are thinking differently at that position. And I think part of it is, you know, you're looking up at that mountain. You know what I mean? And, you know, the Rams had the number one defense in the league last year, and they go into Green Bay, and Aaron Rodgers hangs 32 points on them, and they're out of the playoffs, right? Mm-hmm. The Niners, you know, who's their head coach? Kyle Shanahan. And what's his experience in the Super Bowl? Well, he had a double-digit lead in the fourth quarter with the Niners, and Mahomes made that not matter. And then 3 years earlier, where was he? He was the Falcons offensive coordinator in the Super Bowl. Gets up 28-3, and Brady made that not matter. And so I think like that's sort of like an overarching thought that I took away from you know, week one, was how we saw this quarterback movement in the offseason. We saw teams that normally you wouldn't think would be in the quarterback market get in the quarterback market. And then I think Brady and Mahomes in a certain way in week one once again showed us why.
Albert Breer here on the Rich Eisen Show. You just mentioned about, you know, the Watson – the swing at for the Watson fences that the Dolphins stepped in a batter's box, to mix metaphors, and took a swing at a couple of weeks before the regular season. Tua and the Dolphins won in New England. Nobody's sitting here and talking about what an incredible performance Tua had, like we're talking about for, say, Jalen Hurts, of all people, right? Or some of the rookie quarterbacks right. That we saw, even then they didn't win. Nationally, nobody's saying, well, Tua came out with that W. What is going on with that? I mean, like, really put my ear to the ground here and what you're hearing about Tua and Miami and whether they really are all in, despite our colleague Jeff Darlington saying that the coach gathered everyone together to say this is our quarterback. What is going on there, Albert?
I mean, I think Brian Flores is very well in tune with what his team needs. And I think there was a period there where he probably felt like, this is just me, you know, surmising, that the other 52 people in that locker room needed to hear from the coach that Tua was their guy. That said, I can tell you that the debate over who they should take fifth overall a year and a half ago was robust. And I, you know, my understanding was Justin Herbert had some support in that room. And look, they wouldn't be human if they wouldn't like be looking at Justin Herbert and thinking to themselves, oh my God, you know what I mean? Like, did we make a mistake here? Time will tell whether or not that's the case. You know, but I do think they feel pretty strongly, and, you know, just knowing some people who have connections to that organization and everything else, like, they feel pretty strongly after, you know, three off seasons of building behind Brian Flores and the general manager there, Chris Greer. Like, they've got a team that's not only ready to get to the playoffs, but ready to win when they get to the playoffs. And, you know, it kind of ties back to that whole thing that I said, is like, you know, is your quarterback good enough? And I think there was a time in the league when you could win with a little bit less at that position if you're really good everywhere else. Now it feels like if you're not really good at that position, then you need to be perfect everywhere else. And, you know, I think that that's going to be a question going forward with Tua, is he good enough? Because I think a lot of people in the NFL, and this isn't from, like, this isn't like Dolphins people saying this to me, but a lot of other people who get paid to evaluate this stuff, like, you know, like they watch him at Alabama and it's like, well, he's instinctive and he plays fast and he's accurate. And then he gets on the NFL field last year. And a lot of that stuff just like looked sort of average, you know? And I think the question isn't whether or not Tua can play right now. I think they know he can play right now. I think most people believe Tua can get you to the playoffs right now, right? The question is, can he elevate and can he become, you know, a top 10 type of quarterback? And if he can't get there, does that mean the Dolphins are in the sort of situation maybe the Rams were with Jared Goff, you know, where it's you got to ask yourself some hard questions? They're already asking that question. You could understand why if there's a guy who, you know, is 25 years old and has 5 years left on his quarterback and has already been a top five quarterback in Deshaun Watson, you would seriously look at something like that.
Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.